I played a little poker last night.
Changed his mind since he sent Jabby to talk to you.
Jabby?
The kid with the knife.
Oh, yeah, we just had a little chat upstairs.
The boss decided he has something personal he wants to ask you. He says Carl up to me to bring you then. Coming?
I got a choice?
For the boss.
Who is this boss you're all working so hard for? Any idea what the boss expects of me?
Information.
What kind of information?
Information is what he gets from you, not what you get from me.
Chocolate, anyone? Lady.
Oh, thank you. Well, I certainly don't need four seats.
Okay, you win.
Evidently didn't have any trouble persuading you to call on me.
Well, you know how it is. When the odds are three guns for them to none for me, I'm inclined to be a little cooperative.
Very smart. And now, since the odds are four to nothing, you should be even more cooperative.
Could be.
Sit down, Barnett.
What's on your mind?
Last night on the subway, you shadowed one of my men.
You think so?
I know so. He was waiting on the 59th Street station at 1:30. You were right behind him. You even let him see you.
So what?
So why?
Well, I don't know. I guess whenever I run across a face I've seen the police line up, I get curious. Professional habit.
You take chances, don't you, Barnett? When he saw you on the platform, he moved away from you. You got into separate cars. But all of a sudden, you show up in his car.
More seats.
Why were you trailing him, Barnett?
See what he was up to, I guess, if anything.
And what did you see?
Nothing. He got off at 38th Street.
So did you. Why?
Because I live there. Why do you think I did?
I think you were on a job. I think you saw him drop an envelope underneath the seat as he got up to leave.
I did? What was in the envelope?
Duck feathers.
I see. And he figured if it was a pinch, he wouldn't be caught with the duck feathers on him. Smart.
Uh-uh. Stupid. Because when he got out of the train trying to shake you, he forgot to notice the number of the subway car.
Careless?
Yeah. Now I got 200 grand riding around the city in a subway car, which only one guy knows the number of.
What do I figure?
What's the number of that car, Barnett?
Are you kidding? Listen, whether you believe it or not, I was not tailing anyone last night. I took the night off to play poker.
You're a smart operator, Barnett. You don't let details get by you. Especially one as important as the number of that car.
Very flattering.
So the number was?
I didn't notice.
I'm not fooling, Barnett.
You're not, huh? Well, look.
Just left. Okay, boss. Thank you.
Excuse me, I'd like to explain why I spoke to you a while ago.
It was quite apparent.
But I was...
Look, I'm giving you a break. Beat it before you get in trouble.
Before I get in trouble? Lady, I haven't exactly been on a picnic since I saw you last.
I warned you, Romeo.
Police. Subway police. You thought
I thought you looked too intelligent to be a subway masher, but I think I thought wrong.
But I was only trying to explain to you that I...
Is this a friend or a pickup?
Pickup.
Okay, Bob, come on.
Hey, does the guy get a chance to explain around here?
Pickup's still there explaining to the judge. Your name and address.
Take a look.
Private and Mike Barnett. Oh, poor now, Mr. Barnett. You, above all people, ought to know better than try mashing on the subway platform.
I was just trying to explain to the lady that I wasn't trying to pick her up.
Yeah?
I was in a spot when I spoke to you the first time, and I was trying to explain it to you when I spoke to you just now. Hey, if you work for the subway, maybe you'll help me out a little job I'm working on.
It has something to do with the subway?
It has plenty to do with the subway. How about it?
Well, his reputation is good, but that don't mean anything. It's up to you.
What can I do for you?
Come on, I'll tell you about it on the train. On the inside where the cars are numbered?
That and the same place at the other end. What made you notice it?
I was playing poker just before I got on the train, and when I glanced at the car number, it reminded me of a poker hand. I think I've got it. It was like an open inside straight.
Inside straight?
Yeah, you know, like a 2, 3, 5, 6, and you try to draw the 4.
Oh.
It was made up of 4 consecutive numbers with a gap in the middle.
Are there many combinations like that?
Only 4. 2, 3, 5, 6, 3, 4, 6, 7, 4, 5, 7, 8, 5, 6, 8, 9.
2, 3, 5, 6, 3, 4, 6, 7, 4, 5, 7, 8, 5, 6, 8, 9. That's all it could be?
Unless they start numbering subway cars with jacks, queens, and kings.
I tell you what we'll do. 207th Street is the end of this line where the yards are. We'll show these numbers to the dispatcher, and he'll be able to tell us exactly where these 4 cars are.
I didn't used to have this much fun on the subway when it only cost a nickel.
Special police.
What can I do for you?
Do you know where these cars are now?
None of our cars begin with the numbers 2 or 3. I might have the 4 or 5 thousand numbers, though.
That'll save some time. 2 cars will be easier to check than 4.
You're in luck. Both cars are stacked in the yard. 4, 5, 7, 8 is the head car on track 19. 5, 6, 8, 9 is about the middle of the train on track 21.
Good.
Whatever it is you want, you better be quick about it. Them trains will both be pulled out of here for the afternoon rush in about 20 minutes.
Oh, it'll be time enough. Coming, copper?
Try and lose me.
What's on third rail? They're wide.
Thank you.
try the same seat at the other end. These cars don't have any front or rear.
Another blank. Let's look at car 5689. $100,000 worth of diamonds riding around in a subway car. I bet some insurance company will be relieved to return these to their owner.
You got it wrong, Barnett. It's you who's going to be relieved. All right, drop it.
Thank you.
one piece, I think.
My, about that date I thought you were trying to make with me this afternoon.
Yeah?
Well, how about it?
Why, you little masher.
Barnett, private investigator, duly licensed by the sovereign state of New York. If you tune in this same channel next week at the same time, you'll see another exciting case reenacted from my private files. Many of the situations have been fictionalized, but what you will witness will be portrayed substantially as it happened. And acted on the spot where it happened. You will witness what occurred in each case when I was assigned to follow that man.